Foi o erro. It will be a blessing for you to be among us. And if you have any question, you are free to ask the said question. And if you have any progress of what you can, like anything to advise or anything to help in building up the body of Christ, will be, you are most welcome for that. So I will begin by making the introduction. Let me begin for myself. I'm your brother Moses. I'm familiar to everybody. Amen.
John Mekesa.
I'm Frederick.
Wenceslas C.
I'm Ruben Abizu.
Geoffrey. Charles.
And I'm Brother Tim.
Amen.
Amen.
So, first we want to appreciate brother for praying with us about our brothers who are in the, on their way to the conference. Most of them are discharged from the hospital.
Bless the Lord.
Yeah, it's a great indeed intervention of the Lord. And what I'm grateful about is no one, you know, no one died. No one died. All of them survived. And that was the powerful hand of the Lord. It was the enemy that was resisting that we should not continue with what we had endeavored us to continue. But the powerful hand prevailed. It's so powerful. And also, I thank God for the cooperation of their relatives as well. And also the cooperation of the ministry. We have been trying to raise some money for 15 brothers. And I'm grateful that the ministry here, and even our brothers here, have continued to help them. We are now, it's like we are now less with the $2,000, and it was $5,000. So we have paid most of the money.
Yes,
and that is the Lord, and I'm grateful for every prayer made, and we are grateful for the progress made. And also, special thanks to you, Apostle Tim, for your obedience to the Lord, and for coming to do the conference here in Bungoma. We have seen lives change, families restored, and even in the testimonies you have heard in the churches, even the broken marriages have come together. It was a joy to see a lady at Sibuti who stood when her heart was full of joy. And she told that after 10 years, she had never seen the husband. Even the time she was calling, it was hard. She was just struggling herself with the children. And after 10 years, and when she came here, she only felt that let me also try. If God will do for me, then I will appreciate. But in that mood of prayer and faith, God instantly answered her prayer. Right now, the family is together. As you heard, she said, he never called, and he never
receives calls.
And he never receives calls from her. But right now, he's the one who was calling her after prayer. He's the one who, and you see, he called her the whole night, telling her how he's going to help. What a joy to see that, my brothers. That is because of the grace that God's the grace upon your life. And I want you to, as we come together in this fellowship or in this meeting, I want you to take this opportunity we want to take this opportunity to thank Brother Emmanuel too.
Yes.
To thank Brother John for their labor, and Brother Brad and Brother Ben for their labor in the Lord. This is the investment of the Lord, and the fruits of their labor to us.
Mm-hmm.
And we pray that their account in heaven will be full, or will be deposited more of God's goodness.
Mm-hmm.
Amen?
Amen.
So at this particular day, our agenda was to discuss the future of our ministry.
Mm-hmm.
And we can say, we can categorically say that we have been just, you know, talking about it, seeing it, but now we can confirm that Christ Jesus is in our midst, and Christ Jesus is doing greater things. Even getting that land is a milestone or a step forward for this ministry.
Mm.
And we are open to you, my man of God. We are thankful, know that from our heart, because even if we could not have without you today, even we could not have been able, because we were talking about leasing. Right now, it's not leasing, we are talking about
ownership.
And also cultivating free.
Mm-hmm.
And when we were talking to you, we want to assure you in this meeting today that we will work hard to move from, we will be doing two things, charity and commercial.
Mm-hmm.
Charity will be benefiting the orphans and widows.
Mm-hmm.
Commercial will be paying back the loans.
Mm-hmm.
Whichever amount we receive, we'll be paying back. I can assure you that loan will be paid on time and without hesitation. So I have an able team. I have the team that is able to carry out the activities,
mm-hmm.
and I'm sure we will do it to the latter.
Mm-hmm.
So that is the assurance from our brothers, and I'm committed. As I told you, in school I did what we call management.
Mm-hmm.
That's why in everything, in other ministries, you'll find that you didn't know this, but now let me open up. Africa, when you are going to do the meeting, someone can tell you that the meeting will begin at 10, then he begins at 4. Yeah. So as for us, even if we missed, we had some small mistakes of timing.
Yeah, you bear with us.
That is the position we can say, my brothers, we are better off maintaining time than other people, other ministries, because we have been attending meetings. You begin a meeting and someone just preaches once because they do not observe time.
Mm.
So I think all that I shared with you in the paper, when I send you the program, in the paper I shared with you, I told you that we will have 2 days meeting,
mm-hmm.
at Mayanja, of which it is in these premises.
Mm-hmm.
Of which we did it. Mm-hmm. 2 days meeting was there.
Amen.
I told you that we moved to Siboti. Indeed, you moved to Siboti.
Amen.
I told you that we go to Nasianda and we go to Mateka. Indeed, that's what you have done.
Amen.
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 So I open up this meeting to everybody. But before I do that, Pastor John, can you pray for us, please?
Mm.
Let us pray. Baba, katika jina la Yesu Kristo ndio safi na kushukuru asante. Kwa wakati wa mchana ya siku ya leo tunapokutana pamoja. Kwa ajili ya mawasiliano ambao katika meeting hii iko na mawasiliano. Bwana, wewe ukawe pamoja nasi.
Hallelujah.
Kabla na dimu na pamoja na mtoto wake ndio ni mwako.
Yes.
Bwana, ukaweze kutubariki na kutunganisha pamoja, tuwe na ushirika mmoja.
Yes.
Na hata tuwe na roho mmoja.
Hallelujah.
Hata tuwe na mipango mmoja.
Yes.
Bwana, ukasema katika umoja itawezekana.
Yeah.
Asante mama wa Mungu kwa ajili ya siku ya leo. Shetani anayeweza kuingia katikati wa vitina na anayeweza kuangusha baba mlango hizi katika jina la Yesu. Roho wa Mungu awe pamoja nasi kwa jina la Yesu na Mungu.
Amen.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Most of these people work as frontiers. They carry out activities as they are calling. And I'm glad that most of their time, they always do their work faithfully. Mm. And I'm grateful for that. So the meeting is open, my brothers. Mm. We can all share whatever is in your heart. We can all share. But the agenda is to discuss about your future. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's all.
Okay, for me, I start. I will say thank you for this opportunity to come together as a board and discuss about the future.
Allow me to maybe there's an urgent call from the supplier. I mean, let me talk to him.
Okay.
Yeah.
One thing I want to say is the Apostle Tim and Noah, we are very grateful God to allow you to come in our lives and to shake hands face to face. That is how to say thank you. Mm. Another thing I want to say is we as our leaders, we are very keen and we have to take seriously what you have been teaching our people and us to. Because this is the right. We say from our heart is the right teachings or the right doctrine from the Lord Jesus Christ.
No.
What I can say is we need to be well established. Even our fellow pastors, fellow ministers of the gospel here, we have to be well established. Because you don't want to go outside for these teachings. Because this is the right one. As you have been seeing the meetings we have been holding here, we have been just listening from the people. The people they are saying, it is better you to stay here. Or to equip the people that you pastors so that they can be. When they go out, they have to be have the right sound of them. So we need this word. Because if we can get the word of God, that's whereby we shall be transformed. That is where we shall have reformed. So this we need the future of this foundation. The challenge is maybe the people that are not staying, maybe the good life, lifestyle. We have much poverty, but we have some ways of helping these people. We have some ideas. If somebody like these people, they maybe have maybe small businesses which can sustain them, and then they can continue with the ministry. That would be so good, because we have to use these people so that they may carry this word according to the word of God. So for me, we need, let me just say, we need Bible school. We need Bible school. We are able to hold that, and we are able to teach others with the subject. If people they will agree with us, they will stay with us. If not, they just go, because the world is corrupt now. We are not going to just people. No. Yes, this is the right way. That's the right way. We choose to walk with the right way or the bad way. So this is the right way. We need that way to school. Because even in our government, they need to pastors to have some certificates, of which it will enable them to be recognized that they are well people who can carry the word of God to other people. That's what I think. Another thing, I don't know how I don't know how can I express it, but thank you very much for your heart, caring ministers to give them the word and also the material who are coming. You are fulfilling the scripture in the book of James. The good region, it is care, orphans and widows. So we are on the right way of the world. So the way forward is we need to be sustainable. Not to just pay him all the time some small things. We need to be sustainable.
Yes.
So sustainable.
Not the handouts.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So sustainable. That the way you have been working with Moses, Brother Moses, that is how we can be sustainable. And then also, we know that through this, many people will be encouraged with the word of God. And they know, when you come back, it will be a big change.
Amen.
It will be a big change. Let me promise you, it will be a big change.
Amen.
As you see these people, they have families. We have families. I have my own family. He has his own family. You have your own family. No one is here. Your family. But I tell you that Geoffrey, Open, others, we have families. And also we have some needs too. But we need all our needs to be met by God.
Amen.
That's all. We are not pardoning. Sorry, maybe if well, but we can pray.
Amen.
We can pray together. We can ask God. God can open His ways. And allow people to come also, like to me it's like maybe if you are well equipped or you are well planned, we need to buy you. Because we know from US to come here is very expensive. To us maybe to come here you can come just there to people.
Right.
But mundane to come here. Or your friends to come yearly to be with us because we need this one.
Amen.
To be very, very strong among us. Don't just say and then you go forever.
Yeah.
And then when we fetch you are not found.
Well, you just made me engage with land here, so now I've got my feet in the soil. I mean, Winslow's not going to let me get away, so.
So, we are very grateful to have you.
Amen.
It is a blessing. It's not just you have just come here, like other missionaries we have seen in other places. You have come well prepared for the people of Kenya. And we receive you with the whole heart. We shall work with you faithfully. So, I don't have much. Say. Thank you also to work about the Bibles. That one, may God bless you so much.
Amen.
We are not people who are religious, whereby they just read for you the first.
Yeah.
You can read for us or for ourselves. And that's what we want. So thank you very much for that one too. May God bless you and bless your family and bless your work. You know, we have just been in this house. People, they always the leaders. Some of them will allow them to come on Skype. So now people are asking, as you have said, they want you to stay, to stay, so that we may be also blessed. I don't have much to say, but that's what I have now.
Thank you, brother. Thank you, brother.
Good.
Yes, Bwana asifiwe.
Praise God.
Nashukuru brother Tim pamoja na mtoto wake Mike.
Thank God for brother Tim and the son Noam.
Kwa kukuja kwao tumebarikiwa.
For your coming, we are blessed.
Tumeona injili yenye tumekuwa nayo hata sasa imebadilika.
The message that you brought to us has caused a massive change.
Kwa sababu wengi kama mimi nilikuwa na hubiri mtu akiokoka basi nitajua kwamba anaenda mbinguni na acha hapo.
I used to preach when somebody gets saved, that's the end of everything.
Nashukuru Mungu tunaendelea hivyo.
But thank God this time round we have known what to do. It's not about salvation, it's about knowing God.
Haswa discipleship imenichenga sana, najua kwamba sasa lazima ni baada ya wokovu nijue Mungu, lazima nimwendee mwingine.
Especially discipleship process. We have liked it and we promise we are going to do the much God enables us to do as we pray.
Na kulingana vile brother Frederick amesema,
in addition to what brother Frederick has said,
nitaongezea kidogo kulingana na discipleship, kwa sababu ninaona Paulo wakati anafanya kazi alirudi nyuma kufanya kitu kidogo ya kumstiri maisha yake.
We saw Paul when he was serving God, he came back, he was a tent maker to sustain himself.
Hiyo kazi yenye alikuwa anafanya ilikuwa inashughulikia maisha yake na hata safari ya kuenda kuhubiri injili.
So that he may be able to minister well, to move around without problems.
Kwa hiyo naomba tu Mungu pia atufungulie njia.
I pray that God will open ways.
Tuko na biashara ndogo ndogo yenye tunafanya.
That we may do some small businesses in addition to what we are used to do.
Tukipata kitu kuongezea hapo tunaweza kuwa inatusaidia kufanya discipleship kwa wingi.
So that we'll be able to do the ministry, discipling others in a self-sustainable way.
Jinsi vile Bishop pia alikuwa anatufundisha kidogo juzi.
Like what Bishop was teaching us the other time.
Pia inanipea nguvu.
I'm much encouraged by that.
Sababu Yesu alipokuwa amesanya watu kwa baada ya kuwahubiria walihisi njaa.
That when Jesus gathered people to preach to them, one time they felt hungry.
Paka mitume wakauliza, Yesu akawauliza mko na nini?
And then when Jesus asked the disciples, what do you have so that you can give to these people?
Wale ambao walikuwa hapo sanikuwa walikuwa wanahisi njaa sana.
Because people were very hungry at that time.
Na akasema kwamba niko na samaki watatu na mikate mbili.
He said, I have got 2 bread and 3 fish.
Baada ya kukula walikuwa na nguvu ya kuendelea na safari ya kuhubiri.
After they have ate, they were strong to move ahead with the message. Thank you so much, brother, that you have done this work to be done here. You have enabled us to reach this end. God bless you so much with your family.
Thank you. Sunday.
Praise God.
Amen.
Myself, I want to appreciate brother Tim and Bishop Noah. You are the upcoming bishop. Your coming was not in vain. And as I have been praying, God has committed you to Africa. The message you brought here has just aroused people from their religion. The neighbor women where I stay, they have been coming to my wife asking, is that servant of God going to stay with us for all? We need to hear that gospel. Because most of them are Catholics. And then when in the Catholic, they don't carry Bibles. They just read a strict affirmation of the writings. And when they came here, it was new to them. And they say they are very happy. They want to join us, be with us, and be equipped in such a manner. The word that you brought.
Amen.
Myself, my desire, it is my desire now.
Now
I just congregate with Pastor Fred that a Bible school is needed. A Bible school is needed.
Brother, I'm sorry. Brother Tim, can you just send me that WhatsApp of where they indicate the ID numbers? They want to allocate that land through using the land, the title deed of that old man. The so, ID number, you see, on WhatsApp. Where the document that pertains the ID number only.
So you just need one of the pictures I took?
Yeah. Mm.
It's sending, but there's not much connection, so we may have to give it a little bit of time.
Well, on the site of orphans and widows, it is I have been crying, and my cry is a dream come true.
Mm.
There is light in darkness now, because it was dim when we leased the land. But when I came, I searched the Bible. Abraham was told, wherever your foot will step,
amen,
I will give it to you.
Amen.
Today, as we stand here, we are talking of ownership of our property for the orphans and the widows. That is wonderful. I thank God for that.
Amen.
Amen.
Your coming was so valuable and important.
Amen.
It is going to be written in the book in heaven.
Hallelujah.
So be it.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is wonderful. It is not something we are just passing time. It is the hand of God. We have seen God.
Amen.
When you go back, say, those people saw God in me.
Wow.
In me. They saw God.
Bless God.
Amen.
Bless the Father.
So we want just to, we will be praying for you. And you pray for us also. As today, we are a family.
Amen.
You are not the brother Tim or John or Manuel, whom we just normally hear about them.
Right.
You are the real people.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
And we thank God. We thank God. This is a transformation that God intended to start at this in this end hour.
Amen.
Your lectures from the Bible was so important, my friend. Your father was being used. So I want just to encourage you, emulate him. He's a servant of God.
Amen.
We thank you, brother. As you go back, send our warmest greetings.
Yes.
Speak to our brothers, to your neighbors, those who doesn't understand Africa, how Africa is. Tell them we have established a kingdom of God.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
There is a kingdom in Bungoma.
Amen.
A godly kingdom.
Amen.
So that they might also come in and support you. We need to move. We have been just delaying the message. You just quote some verses. You study, you preach, you say, I've preached the message today. But what you brought was the real message and the word sent by God's people. Praise God.
Amen.
I just want to end there.
Mine
is going to, I've just inspired my wife and my family to pray for Brother Tim, your son,
yes,
and Brother John,
yes,
Ben, and the likes.
Yes.
So that this unity is going to be firm.
Yes.
No demon or no evil will come across and break this unit.
Amen.
Lastly, but not least, I just beg you, if you are not going to be around for a period of time, you sometimes you provide handouts,
mm-hmm.
so that we follow what your teachings are.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you so much.
Amen.
May God bless you, my man of God.
Mm. Thank you, brother.
Amen.
Thank you, brother.
Okay, thank you. First of all, may I take this opportunity to thank you for your sacrificing to be found here in Bungoma. Your coming was for divine purpose. And indeed, we have seen what God has done through you. People have been healed, people have been transformed, people are now rejoicing because of the message that you came with. Thank you very much for allowing yourself for God to use you. Secondly, maybe you have been just hearing Amina, Amina in the Skype, but thank God today you have seen Amina here.
Amen.
Okay, brother Tim. Okay, second, thirdly, indeed, your coming here was to transform our ministry through teachings. Indeed, as you mentioned about building a training centers, this indeed it will help very much because somebody when well, after somebody has been saved, he needs a lot of teachings. He needs to know what is he. Repentance, wholeness, regeneration, born again, and being filled with the Holy Spirit. I hope that will help us and that will make the church grow faster. And therefore, may I request, because since you have come here, can you just make a change here and make a little America here by building teaching centers and providing materials, teaching materials, so that it will help our saints. Lastly, in the future ministries, as you know, you have been traveling, we see that transportation is hard. In the future, if God allows, or if God can provide, if we can have transportation, our saints will have easy transportation from one place to another. Thank you. When you go back, please send greetings to our brothers. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, brother.
Amina.
We are reading around 220. Therefore, so I think brothers, are we comfortable maybe eating as well as talking?
That's fine with me. I don't even have to eat. My joy is in your life. So food is not necessary for me. But if you want to eat, that's okay.
All right.
I would rather I want to make the most of the time.
Mungu kwa ajili ya Apostle Dino na mtoto wake Noah.
I also thank God for Apostle Tim and the son Noah.
Kuja kwao mahali hapa hakukuwa kwa bure.
Your coming is not null and void.
Kwa sababu tunaona kwamba Apostle ama Bishop alikuwa amesema kwamba eti tukaweze kuwa na future coming.
A Bishop was talking about the future.
But now, lakini sasa tumeona ya kwamba tumeanza.
We now have the future begun in us.
Sababu mafundisho yenye Apostle Tim alifundisha.
Because of the teachings you have given to us,
nimefanya kwamba tumeamka katika uzingizi.
We are now awakened. No longer sleeping.
Amen.
Mwanzo tulifikia kwamba tunahubiri ama tunafundisha lakini hatuko tunafundisha chizi na
kuitaka. We thought we are great preachers and great teachers but we were not in void.
Lakini sasa hizi tunaenda kujenga katika uzima.
Now today we have a foundation.
Amen. Naona kwamba mafundisho yalikuwa yamefundisha mara hapa ni hakika ni mafundisho.
The teachings were so good and actually they were from the kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
So na unajua kwamba sasa tunaenda kubadilisha na tutaendelea katika mzingi unaofaa.
We are changed and we are going to remain on that foundation of good teachings.
Na hata wakati mwingine tulikuwa na msiko sana kuhusu mayatima na wachane.
At times we had that burden, that problem, that issue of orphans and widows.
Kwa maana hatukukua na jinsi vile zinaweza kwa shukulikia.
We had no good way to sustain them, to care for them.
Kwa maana vyakula yenye tulikuwa tunatumia, tunanunua ama tunakodesha mashamba, ndiyo tulime. Sasa unajua hiyo nayo inakuwa ngumu sana.
We thank God because today we own the land. Amen. And we can do the better.
Lakini saa hizi tumefurahia sasa.
Amen. We are very much happy.
Mm-hmm.
So, Brother Jim, unaporudi kule Uingereza, wasalimu sana wapee.
As you go back, take our greetings and our love to brothers and sisters.
Yes. Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Good.
Amen.
Is it? I forgot it was a regular year.
Maybe the
potential. We are trying to react on that.
Yes.
Yeah, go ahead.
Brothers, I want you to know that this is not a simple statement. The joy is truly mine. In the same way that you mentioned, you know, it's so different to only hear a voice, you know. It's also very different to put a hand on the shoulder.
Right.
But to come and see your life.
Amen.
Is a true blessing.
Amen.
And more so to come into this country.
Yes.
And to be able to observe the environment,
mm-hmm.
The spiritual environment,
mm-hmm.
The hearts of the people. Also, the hardships of the people,
mm-hmm.
to be able to take note of the forces of the enemy,
yes.
that are against you,
yeah.
some of the veils that remain over the eyes of the people.
Mm.
That's not a criticism. Yeah. It's good to know. It's yeah. good to see it.
Yes.
It's good because, mm-hmm. as Brother Moses said, when we want to move forward, then we know how to plan our steps.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I had written many things that I wanted to share with you, but our time is short.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll try to be very brief. You know, the kingdom of God for so many generations has seemed just like some far away spiritual concept. Something that, you know, we believers have imagined that God will do at some point in the future. And from the perspective of the Father, because of His purpose and His people, how many generations of mankind have come and gone without His own heart being fulfilled?
Yeah.
You know, if I had eternal life, you know, perpetual life,
mm.
and I began to have many sons with a desire that my sons would accomplish something. But they never did. And I watched their lives pass away.
Right.
It would so grieve me
Amen.
That my sons wouldn't come to me.
Sure.
To know what I wanted to be, what I wanted them to be as my sons.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, my heart is blessed. I know the heart of the Father is blessed.
Amen.
to have a people who come and say, please show us the way.
Mm-hmm.
Now, brothers, when I hear that,
Amen.
Then I don't think to myself, well, I know the way.
Right.
But I know the blueprint has been given from heaven.
Amen.
Okay?
Amen. Right, right.
And when I see the blueprint of God's house, okay?
Yes.
You guys, have you seen a sketch of a home, the blueprint?
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's not the house.
Yeah. That is it.
But it shows us the measurements.
Mm.
It shows us the process.
Right.
So God appoints those who are to receive the blueprint, those who are to explain the blueprint,
mm-hmm.
and also those who are to begin to take the board and the hammer
mm-hmm.
and put it together.
Right. Yeah.
We also know that the first step is to prepare the ground.
Yes.
And brothers, I want to say that whatever lack that you imagine yourself to have,
yes.
you've done a good work
Amen.
In preparing the ground.
Amen.
A good work.
Amen.
You know, yes, we have all fallen short in many ways in our teachings and in
yeah.
our understandings.
Mm-hmm.
But what God looks at is the heart. Now, we have a responsibility to truth and to the purpose of God. So that's why repentance is so key.
Mm-hmm.
Repentance is not just about turning away from a life of sin,
yes.
but always being willing
Amen.
To turn toward the way of the Father.
Yes.
Right.
That is for every son.
Mm-hmm.
Every son has a heart and a constant work of repentance
yes.
in him.
Yes.
You see that Jesus repented even unto his death.
Mm-hmm.
He turned from his own will.
Yeah.
That's repentance.
Yes.
Even to turn to the will of the Father.
Amen.
He showed us the way.
Yes.
So let us have this work.
Amen.
Always bring us to a place of humility
mm-hmm.
and teachableness.
Yeah.
Mm.
So, and let us be gracious to one another
Amen.
When we make mistakes,
yeah.
when we stumble.
Mm-hmm.
The word, Jesus, he says, that love covers a multitude of Amen. Sins.
Yes.
It means that even when we miss the mark,
mm-hmm.
the love of God, the purpose of God that fulfills
yes.
his will
Amen.
Is able to overcome.
Amen.
God
Amen.
Is love.
Amen.
He is love.
Amen.
So where are we? What will we be?
Mm-hmm.
As you said, and I mean this not as a figure of speech for encouragement,
mm-hmm.
but God has found a place.
Yes.
And a people
mm-hmm.
in and among whom
mm-hmm.
he can begin to establish his ways.
Amen.
So if we have here a fallow ground,
mm-hmm.
then we must begin to lay a foundation.
That is it.
Okay?
Yes.
So the foundation must be measured.
Amen.
It must be taken care to pour it out.
Right.
And it must have time to cure
yes.
so that it can be strong.
Mm-hmm.
Then we can build. But every good builder knows
mm.
that even the breaking of the ground for the foundation
yes.
mm.
is a glorious step.
Amen.
The Father saw this when he sent forth the stone,
mm.
his son Jesus,
yes.
to lay the foundation of what would become his house.
Mm.
His house. So he was joyful when it was brought out.
Amen.
Many stumble over it.
Yes.
He says he will also be in the same joy.
Amen.
When what do the scriptures tell us? That when the capstone is brought out,
mm-hmm.
that the people who know the will of God will shout,
yes.
God bless it.
Amen.
God bless it.
Mm-hmm.
Because it will be the symbol of the structure
Amen.
Of the spiritual house
mm-hmm.
of the living God where he will dwell.
Yes.
Right.
Brothers, the Lord is among you.
Amen.
The favor of God is with you.
Amen. Amen.
So then let us be encouraged to truly commit our hand
Amen.
To the plow of the field of God.
Yes.
To continue this work.
Amen.
The good work that he has begun in us.
Yes.
And the good work that he will do through us.
Amen.
God wants to have a family in the earth.
Yes.
Where has this people been? Every man has gone his own way,
mm.
even as it pertains to the very word of God.
Mm.
He has taken his own message
mm.
and perverted
mm.
the the truth of God.
Yes.
Let us not do this any longer. But let us be willing to wait until we know that the seed of the life of God is being produced in us.
Amen.
Many years I have waited. I only use myself as an example, not as not because I've attained something.
Mm-hmm.
Brothers, I have not attained, but I pursue.
Amen.
And I want you to pursue.
Amen.
It has taken many years.
Yes.
As a young man, I greatly desired to be used by God.
Amen.
To be worthy to be used by God.
Yes.
Even now, I do not claim myself to be that.
Yeah.
But I know I was sent.
Amen.
So only in obedience do I come to share. Again, I want to express to you, brothers, I don't want a piece of America here. I want the kingdom here.
Amen.
So I am amused by the, you know, the idea that our family in America would have a place here.
Mm-hmm.
But I know that we as brothers,
yes,
brothers,
yes,
with one father,
yes,
one father,
yes,
will build this family.
Amen.
And the world will see this family,
hallelujah,
is not like the rest of the world.
Yes.
Whatever they do is different from the world.
Yes.
When they meet, it's different.
Yes.
When they share, it's different.
Yes.
When they break bread, it's different.
Yes.
When they do business, it's different.
Yes.
When they provide, it's different.
Yes.
There's a responsibility.
Yeah.
There is a king.
Amen.
And the king is reigning in heaven.
Yes.
And his law and his order and his precepts,
yes,
do not proceed from the mouths of men,
yes,
but they come from heaven through his sons.
Amen.
So,
hallelujah,
the word is true about the dwelling place of God, especially in this day.
Amen.
God said no man's hand would touch it.
Yes.
Okay? So let's not be troubled or offended that when we reach out our hand to,
yes,
try and touch the work of God,
yes,
mm-hmm,
that it gets struck.
Oh, yeah.
Let's receive,
amen,
the rebuke of the Father,
yeah,
as the benefit of the Son.
Hallelujah.
All right?
Amen.
Hebrews,
amen,
tells us that only a true son,
mm,
is disciplined by his father.
Hallelujah.
How do you know the love of the Father? When his heavy hand is on your life.
Mm.
So let us ask,
amen,
for the heavy hand of God,
amen,
to be on us so that the mighty work of God,
yes,
can be done through us.
Amen.
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 Amen. Be encouraged. The Lord is, as you said, as you recognize yourself, he is beginning to establish his foundations,
mm,
and his culture here.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
You know, we have a culture at home,
yeah,
mm-hmm,
in America.
Yeah.
Many different cultures, because,
yes,
America has people from many nations.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
But there is also mindsets that govern the entirety of the nation.
Yes.
There are cultures here among the different tribes.
Yes.
There are cultures here within the nations.
Yes.
Some attributes of that culture are good.
Man.
Some are very terrible.
Yes.
In all the cultures of man.
Yes.
Right.
So let us lay down the ways of man.
Amen.
And let us humbly receive and learn.
Amen.
And establish,
amen,
the culture of God.
Amen. Right.
Cultures have a way. We think that mindsets are deep within us. They are.
Mm.
But it's the culture that a man walks in that,
mm-hmm,
produces his way of thinking.
Yes.
So I want us to see how fundamental this work is.
Right.
I'm very happy to hear that things are shaken up here.
Yeah.
Not because I think I possess any power of my own to do anything.
No.
Only that which comes from the Father.
Amen.
So when the Father comes to shake up, to tear down,
mm-hmm,
he says he also comes to build up,
yes,
and bless.
Yes.
Amen.
Now, to answer the requests and the observations for each one.
Right.
I've already had good discussion with our brother Emmanuel as well,
mm-hmm,
who we walk in perfect unity with,
mm-hmm,
according to the Spirit of the living God.
Yes.
our fellowship with him is our fellowship with the Father and the Son.
Amen.
My conversation with him is how encouraged that I am. Brothers, not to see healings, because that's God's work.
Yes.
Okay, I'm encouraged that hearts are changed.
Amen.
Yes. I'm encouraged that God opens a door for provisions.
Amen.
Right.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
But most of all, brothers, I'm encouraged by you that you want to begin the work of discipleship.
Amen.
Now, yes.
Amen.
My discussions with him is that we are going to spend some very serious time together in discussion mm-hmm. and in prayer
Amen.
To try to lay out a plan with Brother Moses
mm-hmm.
as to how we can do this among
Amen.
Them.
Amen.
All right? We know that God has given us this relationship with Moses
mm-hmm.
to be able to directly connect to you.
Amen.
And that he will give us this relationship with you as well
Amen.
To directly connect with the communities.
Right.
Brothers, there is not, in this scenario, there is no white savior.
Yes.
There is no answer that we have from America
yeah.
that will establish the kingdom of God.
Mm.
But God has a plan.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And we are only a part of that plan.
Amen.
We only function among you as his servants.
Yes.
So we only preach the message of the cross,
Amen.
Which is this, that we lay our lives down
yes.
for the will of God.
Yes.
And that when we do it, the power of God will show up in our midst
mm.
and he will raise us up.
Amen.
So let us lay our lives down for this purpose
yes.
and we will absolutely see
mm.
the kingdom,
mm.
the culture,
mm.
the house
yes.
of God.
Mm.
Now, as we look at the history of Scripture,
mm.
every time that the people and the leaders of the people,
mm.
there's only really two times that we see this,
mm.
but when they set apart their lives and specifically to fulfill the heart of God
yeah.
to have a tabernacle
yes.
and to have a temple.
Yes.
What did God do?
Yes.
He filled it with his glory.
Amen.
You see, God wants to dwell in our midst.
Amen.
He will do it in us.
Yes.
And then he will do it through us.
Amen.
And he will dwell
Amen.
In each one.
Amen.
That is a vision that I can hardly contain in my mind.
Amen.
You see, I used to be comforted because I thought, well, at least when I die, all these things will be happening.
Mm-hmm.
Or at least when Jesus returns,
yes.
then he'll come and make it.
Right.
But the scriptures tell us this, that he is to remain at the right hand of God
yes.
until something's established.
Yes. Yes.
Until his enemies become his a footstool under his feet.
Amen.
And we are the body of Christ.
Amen.
We are the body of Christ.
Amen.
So he is the head.
Mm.
We are led by him. We are led by his living spirit,
Amen.
But he will activate his power,
Amen.
His thoughts,
Amen.
His purposes,
Amen.
And his ways in our midst, in the limbs,
yes.
so that we will with him function together in the earth
Amen.
As the man of Christ.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I've seen this before in a vision. The Lord showed me that the day was coming when he would rise up out of the midst of the sea of the peoples.
Yes.
Brothers, I saw him rise up and he began to direct as if he was directing a song.
Mm-hmm.
And he was orchestrating
yeah.
the events of the world. He was orchestrating the directions
yeah.
and the history
mm-hmm.
and the looking forward of what was to come for man.
Yes.
Brothers, I can with confidence tell you this.
Yeah.
The best is yet to come.
Amen.
Amen. But it's not going to be all easy things.
Yes.
Because the scriptures tell us that this is also the time of God's vengeance.
Amen.
And it is the time that the enemy will be released in all his wrath
mm.
to come against the saints.
Yeah.
So let us not be disheartened when we face trial,
yeah.
trouble, tribulation, and persecution.
Yeah.
Mm.
Because it's guaranteed.
It's guaranteed.
It's guaranteed.
Well.
But there's a greater promise
mm.
and there's a greater truth.
Yes.
We know the purpose of God.
Amen.
We know what God's intended destination is.
Yes.
And we will achieve it.
Amen.
By the power of God, we will achieve
Amen.
It.
Amen.
Amen. So I will close with this. Brothers, we have every intention of making a plan and making that plan known to you
yes.
so that we know how to proceed.
Amen.
This will come first as an order of as a spiritual order of discipleship in your midst,
yes.
which we will communicate directly with Moses with. We
yeah.
will figure that out then.
Yeah.
How do we begin to minister to each leader, each
yeah.
brother?
Okay. Mm.
We will at the same time, as a secondary priority, be taking much care
mm.
with, again, Moses, Winslaus,
mm.
these the lands,
yeah.
so that we can look after the provisions of our people.
Amen.
It is important to us.
Mm.
It's valuable to us.
Mm.
We are a people of very limited resources.
Yes.
I know that it doesn't seem like that because we are in America. We have many things in America. That is true.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But our resources are very limited.
Amen.
But I want you to know that our hearts are for you.
Amen.
I want you to know that my coming here will, I believe, the Lord will open up so many things
Amen.
For all of us as a family together.
Amen.
All right? So I, you know that I'm not here to preach any kind of a prosperity gospel.
Right.
I'm just not here for that.
Yes.
But I am here to preach the power of God.
Exactly.
And that he is able.
Yes.
And if you will join me in this walk of faith, brothers,
yes,
we will see the Lord do mighty things.
Amen.
Mighty things.
Amen.
I believe the days are coming soon, maybe even within the next few years, where the Lord will give opportunity for Brother Emmanuel to travel as well.
Yes.
Yes.
Keep that in your prayers, please.
Amen.
You know, there's a lot of restriction on his life.
Yes.
And God has used it.
Yes.
God has used it in a divine way.
Amen.
For divine inspiration.
Amen.
For divine revelation,
mm-hmm,
and also for divine oversight and discernment.
Yes.
So please pray for this brother.
Amen.
Please pray for this brother.
Amen.
Many times the enemy comes against him for days at a time,
mm-hmm,
and you can't even move.
Amen.
But he is interceding on our behalf,
yes,
in the same way that Christ intercedes for us,
amen,
at the throne of God.
Mm-hmm.
So let us lift him in our prayers. Keep our people in your prayers.
Mm-hmm.
You can be sure that we will be praying for you as well.
Amen.
We want to know your requests.
Yes.
We want to take them before the Father.
Amen.
So, brothers, my heart is full.
Amen.
And I feel sad. You know, I don't want to leave you.
Yeah.
And, you know, I pray that the Lord will afford another time,
yes,
soon. But I will take so much joy in the day,
amen,
brothers. When the people, they see me and I give them hope,
mm-hmm,
I want them to see that same hope in you.
Amen.
In you.
Amen.
And then in their children,
yes,
as we continue the generations.
Mm-hmm.
And we will raise, even as with these young orphans,
mm-hmm,
Lord, let's pray that their lives are healed,
yes,
that the demons are shattered,
hallelujah,
that the oppressive, tormenting things that have touched these children's lives,
mm-hmm,
will be completely shut off from them.
Amen.
So that we can raise up a generation that will fully represent the heart of God.
Amen.
They won't have all this religion,
yes,
to tie them down and to,
yes,
confuse their minds,
amen,
and to put a veil over their hearts. But they will be raised up as my children,
amen,
without the veil.
Amen.
And they will see it in your lives. You,
amen,
will be the example of it. They may not hear the words you preach,
yes,
but they can see it in your life.
Yes.
It's like a light that shines in the darkness.
Amen.
So, Father, I bless these brothers.
Thank
Lord, I thank you so much for each one, their
thank
families,
you,
Lord, their children,
mm,
and Father, most of all, their commitment to you,
yes,
Lord, that they have come to you to say, Father, here is our life. Will you make use of it,
yes,
for,
yes,
your glory, for your purposes?
Yes.
Father, I pray that your holy anointing be on them.
Yes.
Lord, I know that there are many questions, many desires that,
yes,
they have.
Yes.
May they come to you. And I pray that you will fill them up,
amen,
Lord. Fill them up. Lord,
amen,
I pray for divine revelation and,
mm,
dreams,
yes,
and visions to be given to them,
oh,
Lord,
Jesus,
that will line,
name,
them up perfectly with your purposes,
yes,
Lord, so that they can have their eyes fixed on you,
amen,
the one who is the author and the perfecter of their faith. And,
yes,
they will know that what you have begun in them, you will perfect.
Mm-hmm.
You will bring it to completion,
yes,
and,
yes,
you will call them as your own sons, Lord. They will fully mature.
Yes.
They will come to the fullness of the anointing of Christ,
mm,
yes,
which,
God,
is the purpose of God for,
yes,
mankind.
Yes.
And you will be pleased, Lord. I look forward to that day.
Yes.
Lord, I bless that day.
Angel.
I bless that day,
yes, Lord,
to see your sons manifest,
hallelujah,
in the earth.
Yes.
Lord, to see the angels,
yes,
and the,
Lord,
principalities,
yes,
have to confess the name,
yes,
of the Lord Jesus,
Lord,
Christ. To see them confess that the mighty God is all wise. He is all knowing. And they will kneel. They will bow. Lord, the gates of hell, you said, will not prevail against this people. Against this called upon people. They will turn it to dust. To dust in every other nation. Every other government. Every other rule will come to nothing. But the mountain of the Lord will be raised on high. So we invite you, King of Glory, to come and rule and reign in our lives, Lord, to have your will and your way, so that your glory may be known to all creation. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, amen.
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 So, Brother Tim, with due respect from my bishop, the kitchen attendants requested before you leave, you have to pray for them.
Yes.
They requested, they say they missed your prayers.
Who is this now?
The kitchen attendants.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
So happy to do it.
Yeah.
I know. Oh, so we have just a little bit of time, but I have to Noah and I brought, we didn't know what to expect for anything. So we traveled with some snacks.
Yeah.
And also I have the books to give to you, Brother Moses.
Yeah.
I think, you know, the brothers would be very pleased to be able to receive that from you.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I have those. So I will go and pray for the sisters,
yes.
And I will have Noah bring those other things out so
yeah,
that,
yeah.
You know,
yeah.
you guys can enjoy some of that.
Right. Yeah.
So, yes.
Yeah, maybe before we finalize, please confine our greetings, special greetings to everybody and your family, especially for, you know, for allowing the Lord in their lives and also for your stay with us. We are thankful, man of God. Another thing, we are grateful for the teachings. Continue to let Brother Emmanuel know we want people to be free, to continue to be free. So the teachings of the tithe, let it be, you know, also be part of, in a part of our lives, because our brothers indeed, as we are ready, and many of us are really seeing that, you know, liberty or freedom,
amen,
restoration and restoration in our lives as we give. So we are committed. Let Brother Emmanuel know and let everybody know who hears our voice. That the family in Bungoma are committed for this fanger or for this wonderful, noble work.
Amen.
Especially on tithe. It is not much. As you can see, our lives cannot, you know, we don't have much. But whichever small, most of the people here give in kind. But those who give financially, all the monies pertains, the tithe, it will get to you. It will get to the account set. I know Brother John is very good at that. Yeah, we will get that to you.
Amen.
To Brother John, to that account, and we know by God's help, we are going to continue, and every brother here and others are committed, we continue to be, to do so.
Amen.
That is, was, I think we have not forgotten anything.
Yes.
We just want to say thank you. Now that time is not with us, please, we should not prolong at any more time, because we are, once we hit the road, we want to, you know, America is not here. I've been on these travels.
Yes.
I've been on these journeys. I know how things work. And it, you know, you need to be everywhere. Everywhere, we need to be everywhere at the right time. Please, Pastor Charles, get the ladies here. We need to pray before other things continue.
Amen.
Yeah.
Brothers, be comforted. You know, I know that the topic of tithe can be very uncomfortable, but it is not about the money. It's about divine order. And that's what we want to be at work in our midst.
Right.
Yeah.
And, you know, those were things that I struggled with many years. But may the Lord's divine order be set among us.
Amen.
Mm.
So yeah, we want to appreciate for what you have done.
Yes.
And we are more than grateful. What a mighty God we serve. So we have heard from Brother Geoffrey or Pastor Geoffrey for that we need prayer, and indeed it was intentional, it was in our planning that indeed that's a photo of thanks we should reach you.
Amen.
You have really done a tremendous work.
Yes.
And then so we know that God is mighty.
Amen.
He's powerful. So Karibu sana kuja hapa. Bali.
Thank you, sisters. I want to express my thanks as well to each one of you for everything that you've done. First of all, everything's been wonderful and delicious, and that's such a blessing. I have felt more than at home. Your care and for Noah and I has been far beyond measure.
Amen.
So thank you so much. I receive it as from the Lord.
Amen.
And I for your service to the brothers and to the people as well. You know, words cannot express, it's more than the time, and it's more than the efforts that you put in.
Amen.
It's that I know that you are serving the Lord.
Amen.
And that you know that you're serving the Lord. I know that you know that. And so I'm praying for God's blessing, not just for the service, but because of the posture of your heart. Because you are receiving from the Father. And so is it okay if I anoint you as well? Amen. Father, I bless each one of these dear sisters,
yes,
Lord, as your precious child,
mm-hmm.
As your sons,
yes.
Lord, as those whom you look upon their heart, and it brings you joy, Lord, it brings a smile to your face,
mm-hmm.
Lord, to see them
mm-hmm.
in the inner man,
yes.
And to know their heart, Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Lord, I thank you for the way that you speak to each one of them in the quiet place,
yes.
Lord, to the way that you speak even to the sisters in dreams and visions. I know that I've seen that in my own wife. It's always such a joy,
yes,
for a husband, Lord. And even for us as the brothers, Lord, to see our own dear sisters seeking the Lord with a whole heart.
Amen.
With a whole heart.
Yes.
So, Father, Lord, I pray that you would bring peace and joy to them.
Amen.
That it would well up in them like a spring.
Thank
Lord,
you.
That your revelation and your truth,
yes.
would anoint them,
yes,
Father.
Yes,
Lord, that it would drip off of their fingers like the oil.
Mm-hmm.
Lord, that everything that they touch,
yes,
would be blessed.
Yes,
Lord, for each of their families,
mm-hmm.
Lord, let them be such a blessing,
yes,
to their families. Lord, I pray that the same joy that you have,
yes,
in them and over them,
yes,
would be extended to all that they reach their hands out to.
Amen.
Lord, even if it is in the quietness of the kitchen,
yes,
Lord, but we know that that's never a hidden place for you.
Yes.
Lord, for you it's no different than coming before your very throne,
yes,
to minister before the saints.
Yes. Yes.
Lord, they have been given the privilege,
yes,
to minister in this place,
in the name of Jesus,
holding hands with their brother,
yes,
Jesus Christ,
yes,
Lord, to touch the saints,
amen,
to touch the saints,
yes,
Lord,
yes,
let them know, even I hear the Lord saying, your prayer is full power,
yes,
is anointed, so never hesitate to come,
yes,
to ask whatever is on your heart, because your heart pleases,
yes.
So Lord, again, I bless them in Jesus' name,
in the name of Jesus.
Lord, yes, in Jesus' name, thank you for their lives,
thank
what a privilege
you,
it has been,
thank
to
you,
see them,
yes,
Lord, to witness their lives,
yes,
Lord, and to bring the testimony of your life,
yes,
existing,
yes,
within.
Yes.
Lord, now let it manifest in so much more.
Yes.
Lord, let it be glorified and be a glory to you.
Yes.
Let it bless you,
mm,
in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
So right now, I don't have the dips, but I have to work on it, okay?
Thank you.
Okay, brother.
Yes.
This is special.
Ah.
This is for your family.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you to your wife.
Wonderful. That's beautiful.
Yes.
Mm.
And this is for the wife of Brother John.
Okay, yes.
Yeah.
Perfect.
This is for the wife of Brother Ben.
Oh, yes. Uh-huh.
Mm. There's another brother that I don't know. There's a lady called Sherry. Sherry, who is Sherry?
Who?
You know, maybe it's one of them.
Oh, that's Ben's wife, Cheryl. Ah. Cheryl.
Yeah, okay.
Uh-huh.
Yes. There's another one. I don't know the name. But we took them. We had more.
So the wives are Katie.
Yeah, Katie.
My wife, Rachel.
Yes.
Katie is John's wife.
Uh-huh.
And then...
Maybe he's talking about Elaine.
Oh,
she's
Elaine
not married,
is...
Yes, Elaine. Good room.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, that's
good.
What I mean. Yes.
This is for Elaine.
Yes.
That's John's daughter.
Ah, yes.
Yes.
Yeah,
good.
Yeah.
Good. Well, wait,
yeah.
Elaine has a beautiful heart for the Lord.
Let us stand together for a picture.
Yes. please come over by me. I want to make sure that when I look at the picture, I see everyone.
Yeah.
Come on, Noah. Ah, bless you, brothers.
Good.
What a joy. What a joy.
Okay, if you have US as well, I can still take it. See?
Oh, yeah, no, grab my phone. You can stop the recording and hand that to Moses.
Where is this?